Hollywood loves a good tornado. Like most things Hollywood, it's all a little dramatic. But flying cows aside, there is something accurate about the setting.
Feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
You're not, but the tornado started there, which makes sense. Tornadoes are far more common in the US than anywhere else. For perspective, all of Europe records around 300 tornadoes per year, whereas the US records well over 1,000. If we move in a bit closer, you'll see that most of the world's tornadoes are happening here, in an area called Tornado Alley, a place that's absolutely perfect for twisters. Tornado Alley doesn't have any official boundaries, but it's typically considered this area that extends from northern Texas through Oklahoma, Kansas, Nebraska, Colorado, and South Dakota. Some people extend it even further east. While most states in the U.S. have recorded at least one tornado, this area is really a hotbed, and the main reason for that is geography.
The central part of the U.S. is unique in the fact that there's this really large, warm area of water just to the south, and the wide, high range of mountains that extend a long way from north to south.
Harold Brooks is the senior research scientist at the National Severe Storms Laboratory. He used to chase tornadoes. Now he studies them from Norman, Oklahoma, in the heart of Tornado Alley. A tornado requires a couple special ingredients, ingredients that Tornado Alley is full of. First, we need a thunderstorm, which we're going to make right now, sort of.
To make a thunderstorm, the things we need are warm moist air at low levels, cold, dry air above that, and some mechanism to lift that warm, moist air up.
In Tornado Alley, lots of warm, moist air flows into the plains from the Gulf of Mexico, and cool, dry air flows from over the Rocky Mountains here in the west. Eventually, a change in temperature or pressure will arrive and lift that warm air up into the cool air, forming an updraft. Once these two meet, the moisture from the warm air begins to condense, forming clouds, and a thunderstorm begins. Under normal conditions, rain would fall from these clouds and cool the warm air, breaking the storm. But in Tornado Alley, there's a strong air current flowing from west to east known as the jet stream. This, paired with the cool mountain air, blows the rain away, keeping the air in the updraft warm and wet, which allows the storm to intensify and brings us to step two, getting the storm to rotate. To make that happen, we need winds moving at different speeds and directions. As you can see, Tornado Alley has that in abundance. The air coming from the Gulf moves slowly into the plains. Meanwhile, the jet stream from the mountains provides a steady stream of high, fast-moving air flowing east. Because the jet stream is flowing faster and in a different direction, it causes the Gulf wind below to rotate, like a spinning football. When the spinning air gets pulled into the updraft, it's tilted, but continues to spin, causing the entire updraft to rotate. Storms like this are known as supercells, and they create prime conditions for tornadoes. They're rare, but most commonly occur in, you guessed it, Tornado Alley. As the supercell grows, the spiraling updraft begins to stretch towards the ground and forcefully pulls air into the cyclone. Air rushes in from the sides, and a spinning dust cloud forms below. Which brings us to the final stage, getting the vertically spinning air to the ground.
Stage three is the friction in the teacup.
It's like using a spoon to swirl tea leaves at the bottom of a cup. The tea leaves rush into the center and are pulled up through the middle of the tea cyclone. In a real tornado, everything around the cyclone is sucked up. Air, dirt, debris, cows. As more and more air is pulled in tightly, pressure builds, and the faster and longer that tornado gets, it stretches closer to the ground until it eventually meets with that dust cloud. And then it touches down.
We see most tornadoes in the central part of the U.S. Because of the ingredients that are necessary for a tornado come together there more often than any other place.
The United States isn't the only place that gets tornadoes. Southeastern Brazil and northeastern Argentina have some of the same ingredients Tornado Alley does. Cool mountain air coming over the Andes and warm, moist air coming from the Amazon. But even still, the frequency of tornadoes is scores behind the U.S. While the right conditions come together, sometimes the geography isn't exactly right.
In South America, the Andes aren't as wide as the Rockies, and the Amazon isn't as good of a moisture source as the Gulf of Mexico is because it's land. It's sort of a Goldilocks problem.
And a delicate recipe. Most people will go their entire lives without ever seeing a tornado. And some would consider that lucky. Others actively seek them out. And those that do start in Tornado Alley, where the geography is just right. Just knowing what makes a tornado isn't enough to anticipate when and where it'll happen. So if you want to know how meteorologists try to predict these dangerous storms, check out the documentary Tornado Season on CuriosityStream. CuriosityStream is a subscription streaming service that offers thousands of documentaries and nonfiction titles from some of the world's best filmmakers. You can get unlimited access starting at $2.99 a month. And because you're a Vox fan, the first 31 days are free if you sign up at curiositystream.com/Vox and use the promo code Vox. CuriosityStream doesn't affect our editorial, but their support does make videos like this one possible. So go check them out.